This is the wiki that I created as a base of operations, so to speak, for the implementation of the data coach. And up here is a graphic that I created myself. And then I just used a traditional wikispaces.com website and named it data coach. And I cited the need on the first page. The need to meet the challenges of accountability. There is a critical and immediate need for schools to use increasing quantity of data now available to them to improve student performance. And then I included some other quotes, including a quote from Parker Palmer, and then the using data white paper taken from the Turk website. And then the Data Coach's Guide to Improving Learning for All Students, which is the book that we used as the basis for the work. And I provided a link to it in Google Books, and administrators could actually look a little bit at the book there, besides being able to have their own paper copy, which Mrs. Spaziano provided them. Then there's a data literacy assessment guide here, and then I embedded the Turk Twitter feed, which is Turk is the organization that sponsors all of this activity, and then the using data blog feed, which is over here on the right. These are two RSS feeds. And then I created a series of pages which I thought were important to the process of completing the study and using data. Created a page for Bloom's taxonomy, and this particular one is embedded. I actually embedded the page in here. This is the visual Bloom's taxonomy, is a useful tool. And then I created a page called Bridge Building. Kind of explains the process. And then I looked at cultural proficiency. How is Franklinville different? What were some of the things that we needed to be aware of? And this particular link is taken right from the Data Coach's Guide, 5 Guiding Principles of Culturally Proficient Leadership. This was really, really important. This is something that I emphasized in some of my meetings with the cabinet. That culture is indeed the predominant force in people's lives. And then a link to Ken Robinson's Changing the Education Paradigm, which I thought was important because it talks about how today's students are different than students were 20 or 30 years ago. And then this excellent TED Talk by Ali Carr Chelman, which is just a fabulous thing about how boys are different and how we're actually discriminating against boys in an educational setting, which turned out proved to be quite an important piece. And then the data-driven dialogue. This included the four-phase data-driven PowerPoint, and then some other links to important points that were raised in the book. And then establishing community, which I thought was extremely important. This is a really important part of establishing a learning community that is going to support the findings, the data that we're going to find in this study. And a link to the Rabbi's Gift, which was a really important group dynamic and community building piece that I found and shared with the group. And then a link taken from Parker Palmer's book, To Know As We Are Known. And then a link, or a quote that I actually created myself and was well received, and Mrs. Spaziano really liked that a lot. And then these are transformational moments taken from the Turk Using Data Twitter feed. So these were important videos that helped to change the climate, or try to change the climate. And I created a link, Food for Thought, which I created a list to my Twitter, or not my Twitter, my Deagle feed, as I created a special Data Coach link here to all the things that I was reading, and as a way to help the administrators think about items that I thought were important, including the CBAM model, which was a mentioned concerns-based model that was mentioned in the Data Coach Guide. And then, the inquiry team baseline data. This was the data that we collected about the school prior to, this was all the demographic data that we had prior to really beginning the study. And it was taken from a variety of sources, including the student information system and information that already existed in other places. And what we found was that there was an incredible amount of information scattered all over the place that in the future really needs to be kept in one place or at least in better track of. Monitoring was an aspect of the book, and so I wanted to illustrate the concerns-based adoption model, which was new to me at the time, and I found this PowerPoint, which I used to explain that. And then Mrs. Faziano asked me to report out on tasks 17 and 18 in the book, in the Data Coach's Guide, and this is a link to my notes there. And I put them up there so that it was easy for the administrators to take a look at them, so they didn't have to write everything down. And then, I thought this was really important. This is taken right from the Data Coach's Guide, and it talks about leadership, collaboration, data use, instructional improvement, culture, equity, and trust. And where we are, and less emphasis on, and moving towards more emphasis on. Equity is a huge part of this whole study. And one of the things that really, really appealed to me and seemed to be very much in line with St. Bonaventure University and social justice and the Franciscan intellectual tradition. And then I created a professional development page, which actually was an embedded link to the Using Data website. These are the people that actually published the book that we used. It's a Turk initiative, and this is, I thought this would make it easier for administrators to go there. Wouldn't have to remember a web address. You could get right to it. And then The Fourth Way, which was one of the books in it that we studied or that I read that contributed very much to creating this new learning community. And then the Using Data blog, which is Turk's Using Data blog, which was an incredible source of information that could keep me up to date with where Turk was going with using data for meaningful change. And I also put it in there to help administrators become aware of some of the things that I thought were germane to this whole process. And then this was a link for our warning and eligibility study, and those demographics are included elsewhere.